Hello, folks. My name is Chris Sensor. I'm a pre-sales engineer with Siemens Digital Industry Software. And today we are going to be talking about sound quality in Neo. Our presenter for today is Pete Sheldenbrandt, also an application engineer with Siemens Digital Industry Software. Without further ado, Pete, it's your show.
All right. Thank you very much, Chris. So today I was going to talk about some of the new features for doing sound quality work in SimCenter Test Lab 2306, in particular in the Neo software. But maybe I'll start out by quizzing you, Chris. So here I got a time history, and if I wanted to listen to it, what do I have to do?
That's a great question. I guess export it as a WAV file, maybe?
Oh, boy. That would be a pain. Luckily, we have a playback button right here in the software. That playback button won't be there unless under File here, Add-ins. We got these great add-ins, Chris. One called Basic Audio Replay, which I have loaded. Another one called Advanced Audio Replay. I like having both on because I like all the fancy options. And so I can hit play here. When you hit play, you can see it scrolls along and you get to listen to it, which is pretty awesome, Chris. But some people, when they're doing audio replay, they'd like to see the FFT, the frequency content of the signal as it's playing back. How would they do that, Chris?
Well, you got me there too, Pete.
You could export it to WAV and then import it into an FFT tool like MATLAB and plot it. Is that where you're...
Yeah. There's got to be a little button somewhere that turns that into an FFT, right?
Yeah. Or even better, under this audio replay ribbon, you got all the great things available to you for doing audio replay, including this Spectrum Live, you know? And now if I hit play, I can see the FFT live while the replay is in progress. That's pretty cool, huh, Chris?
That is pretty cool.
Yeah. And even better, it might be off to the side. So there's like these tools here that you can put off to the side. But this audio replay here, properties, allows me to actually define filters that I can use during the live replay. So for example, I could do this band stop filter and puts these hard to miss magenta cursors on the screen. And then as I'm playing back, I can interactively move these around and remove frequency content, you know, see if certain tones are annoying or not and turn them on and off, and the software will, you'll hear that in real time. So that's pretty good.
That filter applies to the playback?
Yeah, live while you're listening. As opposed to exporting it, then going into an external tool and tried to remove it, then play the two WAV files back to back. You know, you get it all right here, Chris. Are you excited so far for this?
I'm very excited.
So that's a live FFT. And by the way, this was already in Neo. I haven't even shown what's new in 2306 yet. I'll show you another feature that was already here. Instead of a live spectrum, we have this live color map. So here you can see I had that filter from before, but this is a color map. And then as I play back, you know, I can move around the filters and I can see that on a color map of my sound at the same time. Does that make sense so far, Chris?
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, so spectrum map, maybe turn that filter off. You know, there's some of these things, they're on diagonal lines. Do you know what those are?
Well, if it was rotating machinery, I'd call that an order.
Call that an order. Yeah. And notice up here under this tracking channel, I just changed it while you were talking, Chris. I made this a star because there is an RPM in this time file that I highlighted, this run-up, and now it found it. It had some other text in there, like you could have more than one RPM, like a driveline RPM and an engine RPM and an electric motor RPM. And that's using this text with the asterisks, you could search for motor, whatever you want as the RPM. So anyway, with star, it found this TACO. So it has TACO here now. And that means I can actually come over here and I could say, all right, I want to remove one of these orders. And you can see that around this line, I'm removing an order. You see that?
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, so as I play back, it will take that order out, which is pretty good. It's taking it out at a constant 40 dB. So removing 40 dB of amplitude from the signal across this order. But that's not always desirable. Sometimes you might want to take out a certain area where there's a boom or something with a different level than some other RPM range of the order. And so this is finally the first new feature in the 2306. Instead of gain type constant, instead of a constant 40 dB of reduction when I do that order, I can actually say profile here, Chris. This is new. And then if I click on this, I get a
breakpoints in there, huh?
A little tool. Yeah, they look like breakpoints like from vibration control, but you can have as many points as you want, and you can kind of define, if I want to go like in ranges of 1,000, for example, I could do that. Maybe not 40,000, just 4,000 and 5,000 or something like that. And at each one, I could have a different attenuation. So negative 20 here, negative 10 over here, for example, negative 30. And I can basically customize the attenuation, Chris, make it change as a function of RPM.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. So this might correspond to an area I want to, in fact, I think I can even amplify a little bit. I could say, let's increase this area by 5 dB. So 5 dB of gain on the signal here, whereas I'm attenuating it elsewhere. So yeah, you can use this to modify the gain as a function of RPM. Hey, Chris, have you heard about this thing called electrification?
Electrification? That's like when the power line comes into the house, right?
Yeah, you get your house full of electricity.
Yeah.
But how about like in cars and stuff? Have you heard there's thing, electric cars?
Electric vehicles.
Those have some interesting orders. I don't know if have you heard of this thing called pulse width modulation, which there's a nice article on our community site?
Yeah, the chicken feet, right?
Yes, this is the chicken feet. So in the power electronics of an electric motor, there's this PWM signal that it approximates a sine wave and it controls the speed of the motor. And this is the actual signal that's going into the power electronics, this blue signal. And when you do an FFT of it, you get some interesting results. You get, here's a traditional order kind of crosses through zero and goes up with the motor, but you get these things called switching frequencies or PWM signals. They can actually be some of the loudest things that you hear when you're dealing with an electric motor. You had a special name for that. What was that?
Chicken feet.
Chicken feet. It kind of looks like a chicken foot, although that's a pretty big chicken. And it doesn't cross through zero. Typically, a PWM signal has a base frequency associated with it, or a carrier frequency. Maybe to explain that a little bit, you can see here that everything is turning on at the same time, right? Mm-hmm. Well, the interval that those occur at, those turn-ons, they're all the carrier frequency. And then we're varying the width of the pulse that we send to the motor to change its speed, and they call that the duty cycle. Anyway, the FFT of that signal, as the speed of the motor is increasing, these orders go further and further apart, but they're all centered around 5,000 hertz, not through zero. So it can be a little bit of a challenge, if you will, to, let's see if there's a good example of this. your cursor may not go through that 5,000 hertz, for example. So let me, there's another field here in this order filter, and that's an offset. And here I can type in the base carrier frequency of the PWM, and now I can set up a filter to take out those chicken feet. Pretty cool, huh? So that was added with SimCenter Test Lab 2306. So if I had something like a 2000 hertz carrier frequency, I can remove that. Does that look pretty cool as well, Chris?
That is pretty nifty.
Yeah.
So basically you're removing one of those duty cycle orders, and then you can listen to what it sounds like without that.
Yeah, and you see it's green here. You can do that live while you're listening. So as it's playing back, you turn it on and off. Now, in this case, I didn't have any orders that I'm actually removing, but hopefully you're getting the idea here, or at least this didn't have any PWMs in it, this particular signal. You're able to follow that so far, Chris?
So far, so good.
Good. They added some other filters. Let's maybe just look at a slightly different piece of data here. Here I have some white noise, and just look at a live spectrum of this white noise. So what do you notice about this live spectrum?
I would say that's pretty flat, more or less.
Pretty flat.
A little slip,
yeah.
To it.
Now, you know, sometimes people, you might have a recording of something, you know, I'll use the example of a car, where you got a recording of the sound in the engine compartment, but does all that sound reach the operator ear, Chris?
No, probably not. There's all kinds of material in between.
Yeah, which could be represented by a transfer function, right? Like you could go out and measure for a sound in the engine compartment, how much sound actually makes it to operator ear. Does that kind of make sense?
Yeah, is that what you'd call a transfer path, Pete, or is that different?
Yeah, a transfer path would be a good name for it. I think I have some transfer functions here. Just bear with me for a second while I look for it. There's some that come with Test Lab that I'll just grab here. So here, for example, is a transfer function. And if I look at this in dB, there's a zero line, and above, maybe it'll help to have some tick marks on it, for example. So we're attenuating the data by a certain number of dB at some frequencies and then gaining it up at others. Do you see that with this transfer function?
Yes.
And so like if I click here, I can get this very last icon is load an FRF filter. When you right click here, you can say use as FRF audio filter. So
pretty easy.
Yeah, pretty easy. You can see that we selected it. Now, if I go back to the sound that I was playing, that really flat sound, we should be able to easily see the effect of this in the live spectrum. So I'll hit play here. And you can see that, you know, the red, which is the original, is pretty flat, but the green, which I'm playing back, is attenuated and gained according to the filter shape. Pretty cool, huh, for doing a quick listen?
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Good.